something happened that nobody wishes would ever happen to him. But it did anyway. A nightmare turned into reality for us. And we experienced a fire in our PCB manufacturing plant in Hungary. Fortunately, we escaped through the eye of the needle. Now, 14 days later, everything is up and running again. But it was an ordeal, and we kept you informed through our blog, but now we want to share our experience with you through a short video. With me is my partner Luc Smets. Luc, take us back to the Wednesday morning, 1:45 in the morning, very early. What happened?
I will take you back to the 27th of October, early morning. The night shift just started and turned on the machines. One of the machines they turned on is the hot air level, what we need on a daily basis. Now the fire spread very quickly through the exhaust of the smoke of the machine. So we had a fire high up just under the ceiling, and it was not possible anymore for our people with their fire extinguishers to extinguish the fire. Now they tried, but in total they emptied 5 extinguishers with no success. But in the meantime, our alarm system got activated and the fire brigade was alarmed, and they arrived within 15 minutes. Luckily, by that time, we could already safely evacuate all our people. So the plant was empty by the time the fire brigade arrived, but the whole plant was full of smoke. The reason why we had such a thick smoke in the factory is because our exhaust vents in the roof, they did not open.
A smoke escape.
The system was checked 2 months ago. It should have been worked, but it didn't.
Things started to clear. It's almost 10 hours later that...
They got access to the building just to look inside and see what...
how bad it was.
The first impression was that the whole damage was concentrated around the hot air level, the cold line and the galvanic line. And that for the rest, from a distance, the machines still looked intact. But of course, everything was black.
Action
was taken, and the first thing they had to do is find out how are we going to clean this up. So first thing they did was send people to the shops in and around Eger to buy all cleaning supplies they could find and all vacuum cleaners that were available in Eger and all villages around Eger. So we ended up with a nice stock of vacuum cleaners.
I think now we have a vacuum cleaner at every machine.
I think we have, yeah.
But it was good. It creates a positive atmosphere for everybody to say, okay, let's do something about it and don't sit here. Let's act. And the Zoet look is really something terrible. And we saw it with our own eyes. It's not something like the ashes at your home in your fireplace. When you clean it, you can vacuum clean it very easily. But this is wet. This is like tar. It sticks everywhere. If you go with your fingers, you smear it out and it clutters all together. So it was really a big, big job cleaning
and
it all out.
And it stinks terribly. Yeah. It was not so nice. Good. But by Friday evening, and now we're on Friday, we were to the point that most of the machines that are critical for starting up the process were up and running. For some of the machines, we asked for help from the suppliers, and Yukamco was the first one on the spot to help us out. They had the most complicated machine also.
And one of the critical operations in our factory, because it's a direct imaging machine.
That's imaging, yeah. So without imaging, we can't do anything.
Exactly. Thank you, guys. You're the best.
And by Friday evening, we had our first Leria up and running. And by Saturday morning, all 3 Lerias were up and running again. So by weekend, Saturday, we were up and running with all our operations, except for those machines that really burned down. So that is the gold line for the hard gold connector fingers and the hot air level. But for all the rest, we were up and running again. not at full capacity yet. The galvanic line was an issue. We could start only the old line, and also not with all the tanks, so with a limited capacity. So by Saturday, we knew that the galvanic line was okay, the chemistry was clean again, the process was running, the quality of the panels coming out was back okay like before. We did not have an idea yet about the chemical nickel gold line. And then another big job was replanning everything.
Exactly.
We are Wednesday, 1 week after the fire. Production was running again, and we started shipping more and more orders back to the customers. Now, what did we learn from that experience?
Exactly.
A few things. First of all, I think we can state we have an exceptional team in Egger.
Hooray. I second that.
But not only in Egger, we have also a team in Aachen that took the full load after Egger was out, and they worked very hard to do everything possible to boost their output.
Exactly, and they worked also in the weekend extra shifts to make sure that that this volume could be outputted.
Even the people from the assembly department in Germany went to help in the PCB department during the weekend.
Yes.
So that was also very nice. But also our sales team, our marketing team, our communication team, everybody started with high spirit to keep everybody interested, informed what was going on.
Exactly.
And also our customers. We got a lot of encouragement by SMS, by mail, by telephone.
Absolutely. We are very much touched by all the messages we got. And they were really supportive. And it's very good to hear and read all this kind of stuff.
And also equipment suppliers, we got mails absolutely from them and calls from them that say, okay, if you need us, we come immediately. No
problem.
We
forgot one important team as well, and that is the planning team. I mean, to create order into this chaos from the fire, it was not an easy job because we are not talking about two orders. Yeah. We're talking about a few thousand orders, and to get some order into that chaos again is quite a big job before you know what is where and where can it be sent to finish and so on. And all of that, but being back on track in 2 weeks' time is a tremendous achievement, I think, from everybody of the team.
And the last thing, I think that in the future, all these exercises we have to do for security, fire prevention and protection, things like that, we will not see them as a nuisance anymore.
No. It's nice to have it warm, but not too hot.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot. And thanks to everybody, to our customers, to our team, to our suppliers, everybody that supports us. When we have more news, you will hear from us. Bye.